Radha Swami Babaji. Babaji, I have one question. Like, my age is around 40 now. So till now, my life was like a normal life. I had both good and bad experiences. But now I feel that I have very little time. And so now if I got any problem or any worries in my life, then I got a fear that, like, I have very little life now. And if I die with this worry, then it may be a reason for my next birth. So Babaji, my question is, I want to like finish all my karmas in this birth, and I don't want to take the next birth. And so how it is possible, Babaji?
Beta, first and foremost, coming and going is not in our hand, it's in the Lord's hand. No matter how much planning we do, the day we will be born and the day we have to leave, that is already predetermined. You can't change that. Bani says, sab kuch hukumi aamada, sab kuch hukumi jaye, je ko murakh ape jaane anda and kamaye. So that is beyond us. To our limited intellect, we can plan whatever we want to, but it is not in our hands. Now, there is a specific purpose for which the Lord has given us this human birth. He could have made us animals, He could have made us birds, He could have made us anything. So, what is the purpose of this human birth? So, Guru Sahib says, Bhai parapat manukh dihuriya, gobind milan ki eh teri variya. Avar kaj tere kite na kaam, mil saad sangat bhaj keval na. So this opportunity has been given to us for a specific purpose, which is God realization.
Yes, Baba.
Now, rest of the things, having children, indulging ourselves, we've been doing in the lower births also. So as human beings, what is the difference? He has given you vivek, sense of discrimination. That sense of discrimination means that we should bring about a certain objectivity into our life and make life meaningful.
Yes.
Everything that we do should take us to a logical conclusion. So the question arises is, we are here because of our karmas. How do we get out of this karmic debt? Now, by ourselves, we can come again and again, and still that will not be fulfilled.
Yes.
So that is where the shabad comes in. Shabad karma ki rekha katai, shabad shabad se jai milai.
Yes.
So that cleansing power is only with the shabad, with naam.
Radha Swami Babaji, gratitude for tons of showers of love. Babaji, we always believe that it's the best to wake up at Amrit Vela, 3 a.m. to 6 a.m., the time to sleep, eat food. But we are all living in this world of artificial intelligence, where we have no schedules, we are global citizens, traveling every day. It's a different life, a different world. No particular time to eat or sleep or wake up. How can we give our best to 2.5 hours of meditation and be one with you?
See, you've already answered it yourself. You use the word artificial. Can somebody else's experience be the basis of your faith? Everybody has their strengths and their weaknesses. You have to build on your strengths. If you try and copy somebody else, that is not your strength and you'll fall flat on your face. So, don't we say seeing is believing? So, until you don't see, feel, experience for yourself, you're just going to be conceptualizing all your life. So, a computer putting something together and giving it to you, you know, what is it going to do? Your brain will stop working. Because you will, you know, we always take the easy way out. So what is this intellect that we've been given for, this vivek, this sense of discrimination? To experience life and to find and realize the truth for ourselves. Can somebody else do it for me? So, I'm not saying technology is bad. Technology is good as long as it is a tool in your hands. But if you are going to become a slave to these things, you know, I don't think so. They will be robots. As human beings, we will become robots because we will be so dependent upon them for everything. In life, would you create a dependency or would you like to be independent? All these cell phones, computers, aren't they making you dependent? Somebody takes your cell phone away, it's as if he's taken half your life away. So what are you doing? Aren't we becoming slaves to technology? As long as you use it as a tool, yes, it is beneficial. But the moment you let it take over your life and you become dependent, you are destroying your own life.
Babaji, is it okay to have different timings wherever you are and take it as it comes, or we need to be more disciplined and plan it out for sitting?
No, you tell me in life, if the child says, you know, one day he says, I'll go to school in the morning. The next day he says, I'll go to school in the evening. Third day he says, I think night is better. Will he get education? In your jobs, in your shops, you say, I want to open the shop at midnight. Will it work? In your job, you say, I'll come whenever I feel like, whenever I'm in the mood. Will it work? I mean, here there is still a lot of scope for you. You can do it morning, afternoon, evening, or whatever it is, because you don't need a specific time to show your love and gratitude to the Lord.
बाबा जी मैं एक बात कहना चाहती थी कि मैं कभी भी पॉजिटिव ही रहती हूँ, पॉजिटिव ही सोचने की कोशिश करती हूँ, लेकिन मेरे आसपास जैसे मेरी मदर हैं या घर में जो बच्चे हैं, वो कई बार ऐसी बातें करने लगते हैं कि मैं चुप नहीं रह पाती हूँ, मुझे बोलना पड़ता है, हालांकि मैं बोलना नहीं चाहती हूँ. तो उनका कई बार ये सवाल आ जाता है कि 125 करोड़ की जनता में बाबा जी क्या हमें ही शिक्षा दे रहे हैं, जो हम ही सुधरें, दुनिया क्यों नहीं सुधर रही? उस सिचुएशन में मुझे क्या कहना और करना चाहिए? मैं बड़ी कंफ्यूज हो जाती हूँ.
बेटा, जिसके साथ भी मालिक ने रिश्ते जोड़े हैं, कर्मों के कारण जोड़े हैं, वहाँ हमारी साथ में जिम्मेवारी जुड़ी हुई है, तो उन्हीं को कहेंगे, सारी दुनिया को थोड़ी कहेंगे. सो जो आपकी जिम्मेवारी है आप निभाएं, क्योंकि बच्चा तो ये समझता है कि उसकी अकल तो माँ बाप से भी ज्यादा है, मगर आप तो जानती हैं कि इसको अभी तक उतना एक्सपीरियंस अनुभव नहीं है कि ये अपने लिए सही सोच सके. सो आपकी ये फर्ज बनता है कि आप उनको प्यार से समझाएं और बताएं. बड़े हो जाएंगे ठीक है, फिर उनकी मर्जी, मगर जो हमारा दायरा है उस दायरे में तो जो भी मेरे साथ जुड़ा हुआ है, मेरा ये ठीक है कि मैंने किसी के साथ जबरदस्ती नहीं करनी, मगर ये कहना कि मैं चुप करके सब कुछ उनकी बुराई या गलत देखता रहूंगा, तो फिर मैं अपना फर्ज भी नहीं निभा रहा ना.
जी. You have said in previous question and answers that we should not ask the Lord for anything. You have also said that silence is the best prayer. Is it okay that in times of weakness, we ask for strength and confidence and guidance, things like that?
Yeah, I mean, it's look, in spirituality, the only thing you must do is meditation. Everything else is by way of guidance. Now, if I'm not going to ask from my father, whom else am I going to ask from? However, don't ever think that you are trying to tell him. He knows. If he has the power to give, he should have the power to know. If he doesn't have the power to know, he cannot have the power to give. So you are only unburdening your mind. You are trying to find a release through these prayers of yours. Not that he doesn't know.
Baba ji, life ch bohut galtiyan hoiyan, but bohut kuch sikhya unna to. Te, but apa koi galti jaan ke nahi karde, je saade ko jaane anjaane ch galti ho jaye, kise da kade bura nahi takya, ki saade ko by mistake kise da bura hove. But kai wari agle bande nu lagda ki saade ko galti assi jaan ke kiti ya jaan ke unna nu hurt kita. ਉਹ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਨੁਕਸਾਨ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਆ ਕਿਸ ਚੀਜ਼ ਦਾ ਤੇ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਉਸ ਸਿਚੁਏਸ਼ਨ 'ਚ ਕੀ ਕਰਨਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ ਹੈ
ਬੇਟਾ ਦੁਨੀਆ 'ਚ ਆਪਾਂ ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਦੀ ਸੋਚ ਨੂੰ ਕੰਟਰੋਲ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਰ ਸਕਦੇ ਹਰੇਕ ਦਾ ਆਪਣਾ ਪਰਸਪੈਕਟਿਵ ਹੈ ਹਰੇਕ ਦੀ ਆਪਣੀ ਸੋਚ ਹੈ ਹਰੇਕ ਨੇ ਜੋ ਉਹਦੀ ਸਮਝ ਹੈ ਉਹਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਚੱਲਣਾ ਹੈਗਾ ਜੇ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਗਲਤੀ ਕੀਤੀ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਉਸ ਚੀਜ਼ ਦਾ ਅਹਿਸਾਸ ਹੋ ਗਿਆ ਇਹਦਾ ਇਹ ਮਤਲਬ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਿ ਦੂਜੇ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਅਹਿਸਾਸ ਹੋ ਗਿਆ ਕਿ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਜਾਣ ਕੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਕੀਤਾ ਸੋ ਇਸ ਕਰਕੇ ਬੇਟਾ ਜੇ ਆਪਾਂ ਸੋਚੀਏ ਕਿ ਆਪਾਂ ਦੁਨੀਆ ਨੂੰ ਖੁਸ਼ ਕਰ ਸਕਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਇੱਕ ਜਨਮ ਤੱਕ ਹੀ ਕਈ ਵਾਰੀ ਆ ਕੇ ਜਨਮ ਲੈ ਲਓ ਫਿਰ ਵੀ ਦੁਨੀਆ ਨੇ ਖੁਸ਼ ਨਹੀਂ ਹੋਣਾ
ਸੋ ਮਾਈ ਕੁਐਸਚਨ ਟੂਡੇ ਇਜ਼ ਔਨ ਇਮੋਸ਼ਨਸ ਸੋ ਆਈ ਐਮ ਅ ਵੈਰੀ ਇਮੋਸ਼ਨਲ ਪਰਸਨ ਲਾਈਕ ਟੂ ਐਨ ਐਕਸਟੈਂਡ ਦੈਟ ਐਵਰੀ ਸਮਾਲ ਥਿੰਗ ਕੈਨ ਮੇਕ ਮੀ ਇਮੋਸ਼ਨਲ ਐਂਡ ਆਈ ਫੀਲ ਸਮਟਾਈਮਸ ਦੈਟ ਆਈ ਫੀਲ ਐਵਰੀਥਿੰਗ ਇਨ ਐਕਸੈਸ ਸੋ I sometimes question that is it a strength, is it a weakness to feel everything in excess? What do I do?
But as human beings, definitely there should be some sensitivity within us. Otherwise, how will we help others? How will we see their pain? But anything in excess will become negative. You have to be part of the solution, not part of the problem. So, emotion channelized will become devotion. If it is not channelized, then it just spreads your attention into the creation. So learn to channelize it. Learn to keep a balance. If the doctor gets emotional with every patient, he will never be able to treat that patient. So no matter how much pain that patient is in, he has to keep that balance, only then he will be able to treat.
Right. Thank you, Babaji.
Radha Swami Babaji, my question is, this path is supposed to be a path of the individual. So a person's connection to the infinite, his load of karmas, etc. You also tell us to be a good human being. So what I'm asking is, do the qualities of a good human being help us with our meditation or actively following them sort of hinder us? Because being a good human being is in connection with others, in connection with community.
That is the foundation. If you have a strong foundation, you can build as big a building as you want. If the foundation is weak, where will you be able to sustain yourself? Good human being, everything comes into that. Good human being means you should respect others, you should care for others, you must learn to share with others. Everything comes into that.
And this will help us in our meditation progress, progresses as well?
Definitely. I mean, then you are making a strong foundation to build on.
Okay. Babaji, another question about seva. I just wanted to ask if, we take seva to sort of become humbler, become more accepting. But then we also have some tasks which in some way affect other people. So what I'm asking is it important, would it help us to be sort of help if we try to do our tasks better or improve it? Or we should sort of we would be a better sevadar if we are more accepting of instructions?
Well, you have to keep a balance. You see, yes, because seva is always done collectively, we must learn to carry everybody along with us. But then you are going to have the odd man out who doesn't want to do what you want to do, so it's okay to get annoyed with him. Thanks. But it should not be that you're going to hold it against them. Because you are in charge, you have to get the work done. Definitely. Give them your peace of mind once in a while. It'll do them good.
My question is, how can we strengthen our mind from overthinking? And is a pain is a blessing?
Beta, everything in life is given to us to learn. If somebody's only seen success and never seen failure, he's never going to appreciate. It's the ups and downs which make him appreciate. So similarly, pain and pleasure, they always will come side by side. That's how you will appreciate life. Now, where the mind is concerned, beta, we feed the mind. Mind is like the memory of a computer. It was empty. So you've programmed it to sort of start thinking. And so the output is going to be based on the input, na?
Yes.
So if you are going to put too much, nothing is going to make sense. So up to a certain extent, yes, we should think before taking a step. But if I overthink, what's going to happen? I will never be able to take the step. And if I don't take the step, there's going to be no experience. There's going to be no learning.
Yes. In fact, from overthinking, it leads you from blockages, emotional. And
that is what depression is. Yes. It's an overworked mind.
Yes.
And that overworked mind is like a car. If it goes too much speed, it's going to go out of control.
Yes.
So similarly, when you overburden the mind, it is just getting out of control.
And concern about the pain as a blessing, as I...
Everything that the Lord gives is a blessing. Always take. He's helping you to learn, to make a better human being of yourself.
In fact, I find happiness only...
We are not going to ask for it, but whatever he gives us, so when he gives you happiness, you appreciate that. So if he's giving you pain, it's also for your benefit. He wants to clear the karmas. That's why he's helping you to go through that.
Yes. Thank you.
ਰਾਸਵਾਮੀ ਬਾਬਾ ਜੀ, ਬਾਬਾ ਜੀ ਨਾਮਦਾਨ ਦੇ ਵਕਤ ਇਹ ਸਮਝਾਇਆ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਫੋਟੋ ਦਾ ਜਾਂ ਜੋ ਵੀਡੀਓਜ਼ ਦੇਖੀਆਂ ਹੁੰਦੀਆਂ ਉਹਦਾ ਧਿਆਨ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਰਨਾ, ਜੋ ਆਪਾਂ ਬਾਬਾ ਜੀ ਦੇ ਉੱਦਾਂ ਦਰਸ਼ਨ ਕਰਦੇ ਉਹ ਮਤਲਬ ਸਰੂਪ ਸਾਹਮਣੇ ਆਉਣਾ ਚਾਹੀਦਾ। ਪਰ ਜਿਸ ਟਾਈਮ ਭਜਨ ਸਿਮਰਨ 'ਤੇ ਬੈਠਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਤਾਂ ਮੋਸਟਲੀ ਇੱਦਾਂ ਕਿਉਂ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਆ ਕਿ ਵੀਡੀਓਜ਼ ਅਤੇ ਫੋਟੋਜ਼ ਵਾਲਾ ਸਰੂਪ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਸਾਹਮਣੇ ਆਉਂਦਾ ਆ?
ਬੇਟਾ, ਨਿਰਜੀਉ ਪੂਜੇ ਮੜਾਂ ਸਰੇਵੇ ਸਭ ਵਿਰਥੀ ਘਾਲ ਗਵਾਵੇ। ਉਹ ਇਨਐਨੀਮੇਟ ਓਬਜੈਕਟ ਸਨ। ਮੈਂ ਇਸੇ ਕਰਕੇ ਬੇਨਤੀ ਕਰਦਾ, ਧਿਆਨ ਸਾਡੇ ਵੱਸ ਦੀ ਗੱਲ ਨਹੀਂ ਗੀ। ਆਪਾਂ ਸਿਰਫ ਸਿਮਰਨ ਕਰ ਸਕਦੇ ਹਾਂ। ਸਿਮਰਨ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਜਿਵੇਂ ਇਕਾਗਰਤਾ ਆਊਗੀ ਨਾ, ਧਿਆਨ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਆਊਗਾ। ਅਸੀਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਮਨ ਦੇ ਉੱਤੇ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਦਬਾਓ ਪਾਵਾਂਗੇ, ਮਨ ਕਿਸੇ ਚੀਜ਼ ਨੂੰ ਪ੍ਰੋਜੈਕਟ ਕਰ ਸਕਦਾ ਹੈ। ਸੋ ਇਸ ਕਰਕੇ ਆਪਾਂ ਸਿਮਰਨ ਕਰਨਾ ਹੈ। ਜਿਵੇਂ ਜਿਵੇਂ ਇਕਾਗਰਤਾ ਆਊਗੀ, ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਧਿਆਨ ਆਊਗਾ। ਸਾਡੇ ਵੱਸ ਦੀ ਗੱਲ ਨਹੀਂ ਗੀ।
ਹਾਂਜੀ।